Dear friends, welcome to this edition of presentation VBS Osteomed, a series of videos in human osteology available on YouTube. The topic for today's discussion is skull, norma, basalis, of which part 1 we will take up the anterior part. Now, this is a view of the base of skull. There are two horizontal lines shown here, blue and white dotted lines. These two dotted lines roughly demarcate the skull into the base of skull into an anterior, middle and a posterior region. One horizontal line is roughly at the posterior border of the palatine bone or the posterior border of the hard palate. The other horizontal line is at the anterior margin of the foramen magnum. In other words, we can also call it the base of skull facial region, the middle region or the sphenotemporal region, because these are the two bones that dominate in this area, and a posterior or occipital region. These are the three regions. Of which in this part, let's take up the anterior or the region of the facial skeleton. Now, there are two items labeled and discussed here. The flashing arrows refer to the maxillary alveolar sockets where the adult dentition, maxillary dentition is attached. You can see that there are two teeth also in this. The rest are the teeth have been removed. Next in this, you can also see the hard palate, which forms a partition between the oral cavity and the nasal cavity. Now that is shown by the flashing area, that's the hard palate. Let's examine that a little in detail. It has two components. The upper flashing arrow is the palatine process of the maxilla. The lower flashing arrow is the horizontal plate of the palatine bone. That means there are two bones forming the hard palate. I think for further details, we need to zoom into that region to get a more meaningful understanding or better clarity. Now, that is the area we are currently discussing, and let's zoom it. You see, that's the full view. This hard palate, as I just now said, has two components, a maxillary component and a palatine component. The two plates of the maxilla, that is the horizontal plates, join in the midline sagittal plane to form an intermaxillary suture or a median palatine suture. Similarly, the two plates of the palatine bone join in the midline, and between the maxillary and the palatine there is a suture, that is the maxillopalatine suture. That means there are two types of sutures, one in the sagittal plane and one in the coronal plane. These two meet at the middle of the hard palate, and that's shown by the dotted circle in the center. Forms as if some kind of a crucifix kind of a suture pattern. Next, when you trace the intermaxillary suture forwards, it ends in a fossa or a foramen called the incisive foramen. This foramen actually leads you into the nasal cavity. Repeat, it leads the probe is enters the nasal cavity. Important vessels and nerves pass through this foramen into the nasal cavity. Likewise, at the lateral posterior or posterolateral edge of the heart palate, there are two foramina, greater and lesser palatine foramina. The greater palatine is a little anterior, the lesser one, the smaller one, is right behind it. These are also closely associated with the nasal cavity. The posterior border of the palatine bone here forms a sharp border, that's the posterior border of the nasal cavity. The two borders meet in the midline sagittal plane and form the posterior nasal spine. Now that covers the palatine area, heart palate area. We move on from there to see a few items more laterally. There are two flashing arrows, and on the other side there is a single arrow non-flashing. That single arrow refers to the zygomatic bone. The two flashing arrows also refer to the zygomatic bone, but that forum that actually shows the anterior wall of the temporal bar infratemporal fossa. The location depends on whether it is above the zygomatic arch or below the zygomatic arch. So, anterior wall of temporal bar infratemporal fossa. There are two circles, blue white dotted circles, where that's a part of the sphenoid bone can be seen closely in close vicinity to the posterior edge of the palatine bone. Now, on one side, that is on the right side, the pterygoid hamulus of this bone can be seen, and on the other side, that is the left side, the pyramidal process of the palatine bone can be seen in the encircled area. Next, let's see a few more items to almost reach an end point in the discussion. Now, one side, that is on the left side, there are two flashing arrows with label. On the other side, that is the right side, there is a single arrow not flashing, and the label says inferior orbital fissure. That's the communication through which the orbital cavity can be reached. The arrow is actually in the infratemporal fossa. It's a slit through which the infratemporal fossa communicates with the orbital cavity. On the other side, also forming a wall of the infratemporal fossa is the posterior surface of the maxilla, posterior surface of the, that is the upper flashing arrow. Next, a little more behind that, the bone that is visible is the greater wing of the sphenoid bone. It forms more of a floor for the infratemporal fossa. In fact, that slit that you see, the inferior orbital fissure, actually separates these two bones, maxilla and the greater wing of the sphenoid bone. Also seen more at the back, in the midline is the nasal septum, represented particularly here by the vomer posterior border. Posterior border of the septal bone, namely the vomer. Next, on either sides is the nasal cavity. We will describe it a little later. But protruding into the nasal cavity, particularly the upper flashing arrow, is the posterior edge of the inferior nasal concha. Next, those are the posterior nasal apertures. That means the posterior end of the nasal cavity is on either side, separated by the vomer. These posterior nasal apertures are also known as posterior coronae. The warmer bone, when traced upwards, reaches the body of the sphenoid and splits into two leaf-like processes or two plates called ala. This is the detail that we need to understand in this part of the norma basalis, the anterior part of norma basalis. Dear friends, I will welcome your feedback. Please feel free to pen your feedback to this email ID, or better still, please add your feedback in the blog area, type it out in the blog area below the YouTube video. This was a presentation from the Anatomy Department of St. John's Medical College, Bangalore. Also available on YouTube is another series of videos called VBS Histomed. It's a set of 90 plus histology videos, human histology, useful for students, medical, dental, physiotherapy, nursing, and allied health courses. Thank you for your patient viewing. I would suggest that if you have liked the video, please subscribe this channel, VBS Histomed, and also press the bell icon so that you will be informed as and when new additional videos are added to this channel. Thank you.